My name is Vincent.
Some of you have been following me recently as I've been doing this B-Reach thing.
You might not know exactly what it's about yet, but hopefully you continue to read and find out.
I hope so, because it is a very important adventure to me, as well as a life-changing thing.
You see, it all started for me when things were pretty low and pretty hard. I had to take a good look at myself.
You know, I never really quite understood from the beginning what exactly was going on with me. Something that I always had some sort of issue with, stress levels and anxiety.
And I think as you get older and start to go through more or more complicated events, things start to catch up with you, you start to change. Nothing's really the same as it was
and
before.
And suddenly you never would have imagined yourself feeling the things that you felt or thinking the things that you thought. Things just started spiraling.
You know, it's one thing to, you know, have anxiety, be panicked, or feel anxious all the time, but it's something completely different to when that starts affecting your relationships, your family, your work, kind of everything around.
See, I think you have to go back in life and you have to look at your goals and the things that you want to accomplish. And for me, I really only had a couple of goals, which was to be a good dad, to be a good husband, to work hard, to provide for my family, and to make sure that we had a roof over our head, a place to live, and the necessities of life. And so as things went on and I began to have this kind of take place in my life, or have things kind of start to change, it's hard to explain. The best way I can explain it is you look around, you have your daughters, you have your kids, whatever, you have your responsibilities, and those start to become almost skewed, almost detached from how you normally feel.
I mean, I would get home from work and my daughter would come and see me and she'd be so happy and I would love it. I loved every minute of it, except for the fact that there was this underlying nervousness about the situation. And what I learned that was, or when I started paying attention to how I felt, I realized it was because I was unhappy. And I think the fact that I knew that I was unhappy was one of the hardest parts, right? Here you are, you have your family, you have everything that you've kind of dreamed of and wanted, and you look at it and you don't have a sense of happiness anymore, or you feel cheated or confused or wronged in some way.
And then the thoughts of all the people who want this but don't have it, who would do anything to be in your situation, come in, then you start feeling guilt, and you start to become blinded as to what's really going on. You think your life is just full of unhappiness or hate or anger, because those are the symptoms, those are the things that you have going on around you, and you mix them with guilt and emotion, and you lose track of what the actual problem is, or even looking for the actual problem.
And I mean, we all have our fair share of issues, right? We all have our problems. We all have the things that we go through on a daily basis, the things that stress us out, the things that make us mad, angry, whatever you want to call it, right? We all have those. I'm not any different than anybody else. My particular struggle happens to be anxiety. But what I'm trying to get at right now, and what I'm trying to help you all see, is the fact that, you know, at a point where I was at near complete breakdown, you know, I'll go more into the story at a later time, but I was at a point where I was done. I was absolutely done. And, you know, I even had a leader of mine say to me, "I heard you were done." And that, you know, these are eye-opening moments. But the thing that I'm trying to get at right now is something that I learned a long time ago, is that the behaviors that people have, the things that you see, are expressions of a belief that they have within themselves. And sometimes they don't even know what that belief is.
But the belief that they have is trying to help them to meet a need that they have. And when you start confusing those needs or not understanding those needs, or lose sight of those needs, you start to lose sight of those beliefs as well. And I had lost sight of a lot of things. But I think the biggest one was what makes somebody happy. And then, as well as I believed that life was unfair. I had that belief that life was unfair and my life was just meant to be unhappy and I was supposed to endure it. And that's when I gave up on myself. But then something interesting happened. When I had given up on myself, there were people around me who hadn't. And I finally opened my mouth and I finally started talking about, even in the littlest form, that something was wrong. And I let people start to see that. And then people started to reach out to me. People started to talk to me. People started to tell me how much they loved me and how much I meant to them and ask me questions and ask me all the things that, you know, I had wanted and that I had felt that life was unfair for, that I had felt ignored and felt alone. But it was the moment that I started talking about it, even though it probably wasn't easy for anyone to hear. People started reaching out to me and they touched my heart. And for the first time in years, I felt some sort of sense of belonging. And this allowed me to really visit what was going on inside, and start to recognize the true problem, because it took a good hard fall in order to get that belief away from me that life was unfair, and that I didn't matter. It took me pretty much losing myself mentally altogether. But as soon as that happened, that's when the help rolled in. And that's what this is all about. This is what my idea of being reached, and when I say be reached, it's you can't do it on your own. Life's not meant to be done alone. And we bottle up our feelings inside and we try and keep them to ourselves and we try and make sure everybody sees how strong we are. But it's, you know, what helps us in life, what gets us by and what helps us grow. And an absolute necessity in life is to be reached and to be loved.